Every year, 15 million people worldwide suffer a stroke, and out of those, 6 million perish and 5 million more are left permanently disabled. Carotid artery disease is estimated to be the source of a stroke in about one-third of those cases, and in the U.S., there are 400,000 new diagnoses of carotid artery disease made every year.
When I wake up, I raise my arms and stretch. Well, this left arm came crashing down like it had a weight in it.
That was the first time 78-year-old Jan Myers started having trouble with his carotid artery back in 2012. It happened again earlier this year.
This past January, I woke up one morning, raised my arms, and this one came crashing back down.
After several tests at Northeast Baptist Hospital,
the hospitalist came in after reviewing the test, and he said, "Son, you've got a major problem. You're not leaving this building until we fix it."
The thought has been, is there a way to improve the safety of high-risk patients that need carotid surgery?
That's where TCAR, or transcarotid artery revascularization, comes in. It uses direct access to the carotid artery and an advanced system for temporarily reversing blood flow during the delivery of a stent. That keeps debris moving away from the brain, reducing the risk of a stroke.
This technology was invented for high-risk people that needed a minimally invasive way to fix their artery.
With flow reversal established, the conformable en-route transcarotid stent is placed to stabilize the plaque against the wall of the artery and minimize the potential for a future stroke.
Northeast Baptist and St. Luke's Baptist were the first facilities that were doing this minimally invasive procedure.
The procedure gave Myers a new lease on life.
I no longer have to look over my shoulder to see if the Grim Reaper's creeping up on me.
Jeremy Baker, KENS 5 Eyewitness News.